Hello friends, welcome to Perf Metrics, the core performance testing YouTube channel. Continue with the tips and tricks video series. In this video, we will discuss a very common question, that is when to start performance testing phase in SDLC, means software development lifecycle. So quickly let's have a look at typical SDLC, which has six major phases: planning, requirement analysis, designing, development, testing and deployment. Now we will see at which point performance testing should be started. Since software development lifecycle is started from the planning phase, so it is good idea to involve a performance architect at the initial phase of software development. His inputs in the beginning phase help to plan a responsive software system which can handle the desired load. One point to be noted here: performance architect and solution architect both have different roles and responsibilities. Solution architect prepares a plan or design the core architect of the software system. On the other hand, performance architect just provide input to build a twin software system. Solution architect thinks about software solution according to client's need, whereas performance architect thinks to make a software solution better in terms of performance. Next is requirement analysis. The requirement analysis phase of software development lifecycle helps to get all the requirement related to build a software. But somehow performance requirements are always missed. This happens because more stress is given to collect the business and functionality related requirement in the phase and parked NFRs. Another reason could be performance test execution starts after functional test, so maybe solution architect thinks to collect the NFRs in the later phase, which is not a good idea. If you do not know how much load handling software system you need to create, then how to design a twin application system? If a performance architect involves, then he reminds to collect the non-functional requirement in the requirement analysis phase itself. A pre-tuned application is better than the application which needs to be tuned in the later phases. It saves both time and money. Once the functional and non-functional requirement are finalized, then software designing phase is started. Although there is no such involvement of performance testing team in this phase, except just providing inputs to design a tuned software system. This time can be utilized to onboard performance tester in the project, and performance architect can transfer the knowledge of application to performance testers who will prepare the test script and execute the test. Like designing phase, development phase of software development lifecycle does not require any involvement of performance testing team. Again, this time can be utilized to prepare performance test plan and strategy. A detailed performance testing approach should be designed, which should contain the critical business flow, test scopes, required test data, performance test environment sizing, NFRs, etc. Another task is preparation of performance testing environment, which is done by IT team, but get the inputs from the performance testing team. In this phase, a performance tester gets a good time to complete the planning tasks, especially when a new application is being developed. In the next phase, that is testing phase, different types of testings are lined up, which also includes performance testing. I hope I do not want to describe the testing phase of SDLC, but better to discuss some key points related to performance testing. Like, you can start test scripting in QA environment in case performance testing environment is not built up. Always use functionally tested and QA passed code for performance testing. Create a realistic workload model. Execute the test in live-like or 50% scale down environment. Always validate the result against defined NFRs. Always include server states along with core performance testing metrics, etc. Once the test execution is completed by meeting all the defined NFRs, then provide a green sign off, else flag it as red and raise no go concern to the project team. Ideally, an application or piece of functionality should only be live when it gets go live sign off from all the testing teams. If you want to understand performance testing lifecycle in detail along with practical example, then refer to PerfMetrics article on PTLC, and its link has been given in the description section of this video. So that's it in this video. For more tips and tricks for performance testing and engineering, stay connected with PerfMetrics, the core performance testing YouTube channel.